He was stranded in a tiny town on Fair Prince Edward Island, waiting for a ship to come and find him. A one horse place, a friendly face, some coffee, and a tiny trace of fiddling in the distance far behind him. And a dime across the counter lane, a shy hello, a brand new friend, and a walk along the street in the wintry weather. A yellow light, an open door, and a welcome friends, there's room for more, and then they're standing there inside together. He said, I've heard that tune before somewhere, but I can't remember when. Was it on some other friendly shore? Did I hear it in the wind? Was it written on the sky above? I think I heard it from someone I love, but I haven't heard a tune so sweet since then. And his feet begin to tap, and a little boy says, I'll take your hat. He's caught up in the magic of her smile. Then leaped the heart within him went, as off across the floor he sent his clumsy body, graceful as a child. He said, there's magic in the fiddler's arm, there's magic in this town, there's magic in the dancer's feet and the way they put them down. People smiling everywhere, boots and ribbons, locks of hair, laughter, old blue suits and Easter gowns. On the room is bare, the old piano sitting there, someone's hat's left hanging on the bar. The empty chairs, the wooden floor that feels the touch of shoes no more, waiting for the dancers to come by. And the fiddle's in the closet of some daughter of the town. The strings are broke, the bow is gone, and the cover's buttoned down. But sometimes on December nights, when the air is cold and the wind is right, there's a melody that passes through the town.
You know, you meet the lads. This is Declan on the keyboards over here. Geraldine on the cello. Hasn't played anything yet, but she will. Martin Murray on the fiddle. He's usually on the fiddle. Paul Grant on the guitar. And I'm Liam. Probably one of the most requested songs that I've done over the years. It's been the song written by Ewan McCall. He made some lovely songs. He did it for a program on the BBC called Singin' the Fishin'. And what he did to make the song was that he took the words, he tape recorded all the old fishermen up along the east coast of England. And he never used one word of his own or one line of his own. All he did was he rhymed the lines that the fishermen had given him. And he made it into a song called The Shoals of Herring. With our nets and gear, we're fair. On the wild and wasteful ocean, it's out there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bonny shore,
of Halloween. It was on a fair and a pleasant day, out of Yarmouth Harbour I was fain. As a cabin boy or a sailing lover, for to hunt the bonny shoals of heaven. Oh, we left the home grounds in the month of June, and for canny shields we soon were bearing, with 100 crown of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of Ann. Now the work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing, and I used to sleep standing on me feet, and I dream about the shoals of hell. Now you're up on deck, you're a fisherman, and you're learning all about seafaring. That's your education, scraps of navigation, as you hunt the bonny shoals of herring. In the stormy seas and the living gales, I earned the gear that I was wearing. Sailed 10,000 miles, caught 10 million fishes, as we hunted for the shoals of hell. And it's night and day we're faring. Come winter wave or winter gale, sweating or cold, growing up, growing old, or dying, as we hunt the bonny shores of herring.
I love some of the Scottish songs. I'm very fond of the Scottish songs and poetry, particularly the poetry of Robert Burns. He's one of my favorite poets, one of my favorite people in all of literature. He was a wild man for the women, you know, and he was called the ploughman poet, but he spent an awful lot of time over the ditch, I know that. Back in his home place in Ayr in Scotland, they still say about Burns, Robbie, he was a wild one. If you threw a stone over a ditch and hit a child, more than likely it would be one of his own. Who could dislike a man like that? But he made some of the most profound statements in all of English literature. And he was so articulate about it too. He said one time when he ran through a mouse's nest with the plow, and it lay there broken on the ground and winter coming on, and he was wondering what is the little mouse and its family going to do? And he said, listen to this incredible English. Wee sleekit, cowrin, timorous beastie, oh, a panics and the breastie, and needna start to war so hasty with bicker and brattle. I would be laid to rin and chase thee with murder and paddle. I'm truly sorry that man's dominion has broken nature's social union and justifies the ill opinion which makes thee startle at me, thy poor earth-born companion and fellow mortal. He said that. You don't believe that, Dick. Of course, he also said, man's inhumanity to man makes countless thousands more. Great word. Nothing to do with Robbie Burns, a little song called the Loch Tay Boat Song. Waters of
of Lochtea, as the evening sun is setting, and I gaze upon Ben Lawers, where the afterglory glows, and I think unto bright eyes and the melting mount below. She's my beauteous name, my joy and sorrow too, and if she prove untrue, well, I cannot live without her, for my heart's a boat in tow, and I'd give the world to know why she means to let me go. As I sing, and rue your lovely hair has more glamour, I declare, than all the tresses wear between Killeen and Aberfeldy. May they lint white, brown or gold, may they blacker than the snow, they're no more worth to me than the melting flake of snow. And her eyes are like the gleam of the sunlight on the stream, and the songs the fairies sing seem like songs she sings at melting. But my heart is full of love, for last night she bade me go, and the tears begin to flow as I sing.
Tell you about Michael Day.
Michael Day, well, he talked kind of funny too, because he come from Boone, North Carolina, you know. He real old when he died. Before he died, he sent me a song on a cassette tape all about his life. And, well, you know, he had never taken a drink in his life. He didn't drink, he didn't smoke, he didn't go with bad women, he might as well have been dead. I mean, he was just like Declan here, you know. None of them things ever crossed his mind. But when he discovered what he'd been missing when he was 80, he decided he just refused to die. He wanted to test everything. And this is a song that he sent to me on a cassette tape about his whole life, and I'm going to give it to you. And you all are going to sing it with me now, I know. It says, it's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. The sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world begun. God damn, I love that chord. Well, he said, like I say, he was real old, so he sang kind of crusty like this. Oh, it's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. The sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world begun. Next time around, now I know that y'all gonna sing it. When I was 80, I started smoking, took to drinking at 85. At 90, I started courting. Thank God that I was alive. At 95, I took to the gambling, determined to rake in the pile. At 100, I made my first million. Whoopee. Man, I started living in style. Oh, here she comes. It's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. Oh, the sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world began. Well, I moved to an uptown penthouse, used 50s to light my cigars, developed a taste for fine champagne, and drove fast Italian cars. But the doctor, he gave me a warning and a lecture on right and wrong. If I didn't give up my sinful ways, I couldn't live very long. I said to him, I said, it's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. The sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world begun. It's real sad from here on in now. Now I'm a 200-year-old alcoholic, and the nicotine's caught up on me. But worst of all, in this morning's mail, I got a suit for paternity. But I'm not really unhappy, 'cause maybe I'll have me a son, and his mornings will be just as shiny as the first day the world begun. Oh, here it comes. It's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. The sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world once like you mean it. Oh, it's never too late to start living, to get out and have some fun. The sun will be just as shiny in the morning as the first day the world begun. I'm digging it up.
Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows. Fair is the lily of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the Boyne. But my love is fairer than any. Come over the hills to your dark. You choose the road, love, and I'll make the vow. And I'll be your true. Yonder garden grows. Fair is the lily of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the Boyne. My love is fairer. Down by Killarney's green woods that we strayed when the moon and the stars, they were shining. The moon shone its rays on our locks of golden hair, and she swore she'd be my love. In yonder garden there is the lily of the valley, and clear is the water that flows from the moon. But my love is fairer. Is not for the parting with my sister Kate. 'Tis not for the grief of my mother. 'Tis all for the loss of my bonny Irish lass. And my heart is breaking.
God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire and some just clap their hands or paws or anything. Anything you got, you clap. Anything. Oh. Yo ya ke ko ya. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got. Now all God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got. Now. Listen to the bass, it's the one on the bottom where the bullfrog croaks and the hippopotamus moans and groans with a big to-do. And the old cow just goes boo. The dogs and the cats, they take up the middle where the honeybee hums and the cricket fiddles, the donkey brays and the pony neighs and the old ray badger sighs. Oh, all God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got now. Listen to the top with the little birds singing and the melodies and the high notes ringing and the hoot owl cries over everything and the blackbird disagrees. Singing in the nighttime, singing in the day, the little duck quacks and he's on his way. The otter hasn't got much to say and the porcupine talks to himself. Oh, all God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got now. It's a simple song, a living song everywhere by the ox and the fox and the grizzly bear, the grumpy alligator and the hog above, the sly old weasel and the turtle dove. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got. Now all God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, paws, or anything they got now. This is a real song. It's about an old couple who know what love is all about because their love has been tempered by the tough times as well as the good times. And there's an awful lot of friendship gone into their love, which is really what it's all about in the long run when everything else gives out. Right, Paul? The old man is... So we say down in Tipperary, he's away with the fairies. His wife, Margaret, is a great bird. I love her. She follows him in the day when he can't find his way home. She leads him back through the cobble streets of Amsterdam. What I like best about her is always in the cold of the evening, she puts a little whiskey in his tea to warm him up and cheer him up. And you can take all the romantic songs that you want, but to me, that is a love song. Whiskey and the tea is great. The chorus, if you want to sing it nice and quietly with us, says, let us go to the banks of the ocean where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. It's called The Dutchman. Dutchman's not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam that holds his dreams in. Well, that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snow. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuyder Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that free. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes, his cap and coat are patched with love that Margaret sewed in. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again, through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks that he's alone, and he calls her name. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuyder Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers. Windmills swirl the winter in, she winds his muffler tighter. They sit in the kitchen. The tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name. She makes his bed up, humming some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two. They hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep, and Margaret blows the candle out. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuyder Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Way back in the 60s, my brothers, myself, and Tommy Makem had a kind of a hit with a song called The Irish Rover. And I was delighted to see friends of ours, the Dubliners, and the Pogues coming out with this again and going to the top of the charts with the thing. Wasn't that amazing? Such a great old clinker of a song. But they were performing, the Pogues, of course, originally called the Pogue Mahones, you know that. They performed in Boston at Symphony Hall, and the reviewer from the Boston Globe, which is a rather stuffy paper, the only way to describe him, he said, is a cross between the Clancy Brothers and the Sex Pistols. That was an interesting piece of cross-pollination there. Here's the song they sang. There's a line in here somewhere. See if you can find it. In the year of our Lord, 1806, we set sail from the cold Cay of Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. We'd an elegant craft, she was rigged fore and aft, and how the trade winds drove her
she had 23 masts. She stood several blasts, they called her the... There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. We had Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a chap from Westmeath named Malone. We had Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man Mick McCann from the banks of the Ban was the skipper on the... We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags. We had 2 million barrels of bone. We had 3 million bales of our nanny goat's tails. We had 4 million barrels of stone. We had 5 million hogs' eye and 6 million dogs. 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million sights of our blind horses' height in the hold of the... We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in a fog.
Hey, wait a minute. What? But you had one line, and you blew it. Great fog. Come on, we try it again.
We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost her way in a fog. And the wind was reduced down to two, myself and the captain's old dog, Big Gun. The ship's rather up, all large water shock, and nearly tumbled over, turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rovers.
Right, I'm going to sing you the band played Waltz in the Tea. If I can get this Japanese guitar in tune.
Oh, my God. I wonder if the Edge ever has problems like this.
The only way to tune Japanese guitars, I've discovered, is to sing to them. Twisting the knobs doesn't work.
Koyake de igakure te yamano otera no kane ganaru o te te tsona ide minakaero karasu to issho ni kaerimashou.
Works. It's a very angry song, written about the Great War, or the 1914-18 War. It was called the Great War back before they started numbering them. At the time it was going on, let me just tell you a little bit about what was happening. We were told, historically, we were told that we were fighting for the freedom of small nations. In actual fact, to this day, nobody knows what the hell the First World War was fought for. Something about the Kaiser and somebody being shot, you know. Millions and millions and millions of young men lost their lives in that. Yeats was living in Dublin at the time, and he was founding the Abbey Theatre with Lady Gregory. Her son joined up, Robert Gregory. He joined up and he became an airman. Yeats wrote a famous poem called An Irish Airman Foresees His Death. He was shot down after about, I think something like 15, 20 minutes in the air. He was shot down over Italy and he's buried there. In the meantime, the Black and Tans had come to Ireland to quell the rebellion. And the atrocities that they committed out in the west of Ireland where Lady Gregory was living have to be read in her journals to be believed, where they took young men from their houses, shot them in front of their parents, or tied them to the back of trucks, lorries, by the feet, and drove them over rough country roads until their heads were worn off. Yeats wrote this letter by way of a poem to young Robert Gregory, who was already dead in Italy. Some 19 German planes, they say, you had brought down before you died. We called it a good death. Today, can ghost or man be satisfied? Although your last exciting year outweighed all other years, you said, though battle joy may be so dear a memory even to the dead, it chases other thought away. Yet rise from your Italian tomb, flit to Kiltartan Cross, and stay till certain second thoughts have come upon the cause you served, that we imagined such a fine affair. Half drunk or whole mad soldiery are murdering your tenants there. Men who revere your father yet are shot down now on the open plain. Where may new married women sit and suckle children now? Armed men may murder them in passing by, nor law nor parliament take heed. And then close your eyes with dust and lie among the other cheated dead. Now when I was a young man, I carried my pack, and I lived the free life of the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time to stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat, and they gave me a gun. And they sent me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. Amid all the tears, flag waving and cheers, we sailed off for Gallipoli. Well, I remember that terrible day when our blood stained the sand and the water, and how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turk, he was ready, oh, he'd primed himself well. He rained us with bullets, and he showered us with shell. And in 5 minutes flat, we were all blown to hell. Nearly blew us back home. And the band played Waltzing Matilda when we stopped to bury our slain. And we buried ours, and the Turks buried theirs. Then it started all over again. Those who were living just tried to survive in that mad world of blood, death, and fire. And for 10 weary weeks, I kept myself alive, though around me the corpses piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked my arse overhead, and when I awoke in my hospital bed and saw what it had done, wished I were dead. Never knew there were worse things than dying. For no more I'll go waltzing Matilda all around the green bush far and near. content and pace. A man needs both legs. No more waltzing. Collected the wounded, the crippled, the maimed. They shipped us back home to Australia. The armless, the legless, the blind, the insane. Those proud, wounded heroes of Sula. And when the ship pulled into Circular Quay, I looked at the place where my legs used to be. Thank Christ, there was no one there waiting for me. To grieve and to mourn and to pity. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. Nobody cheered. They just stood there and stared, and they turned all their faces away. So now, every April, I sit on my porch, and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, renewing their dreams of past glory. I see the old men, all tired, stiff and sore, the weary old heroes of a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. And the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Waltzing Matilda, who'll come waltzing Matilda with me? And their ghosts may be heard as they march by the billabong. Who'll come waltzing Matilda with me?
I was a highwayman, along the coach roads I did ride, sword and pistol by my side. Many a young maid lost her baubles to my trade. Many a soldier shed his lifeblood on my blade. The bastards hung me in the spring of 25, but I am still alive. I was a sailor, I was born upon the tide, with the sea I did abide. I sailed a schooner round the Horn to Mexico. I went aloft to furl the mainsails in a blow. And when the yards broke off, they say that I got killed, but I am living still. I was a damseler, crossed the river deep and wide, where steel and water did collide, a place called Boulder on the wild Colorado. I slipped and fell into the wet concrete below. They buried me in that great tomb that knows no sound, but I am still around. I'll always be around and around and around. I fly a starship across the universe divide, and when I reach the other side, I'll find a place to rest my spirit if I can. Perhaps I may become a highwayman again, or I may simply be a single drop of rain, but I will remain. I'll be back again and again and again. Come down, come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? We try it again, you sing it twice as loud. Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Oh! In Yarmouth town there lived a man, and he kept a tavern by the strand. The landlord had a daughter fair, a pretty little thing with a golden hair. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Now in this tavern was a sailor man, and he asked the daughter for her hand. Why should I marry you, she said, when I get all I want without being wed? Oh, won't you come down, oh, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town now? You want to linger, I'll tie a piece of string all around my finger, and all you got to do is pull on the string. I'll come down and I'll let you in. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? So at closing time the sailor man went back to the tavern by the strand. He'd never seen such a sight before. The string on her finger was all she wore. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Oh, won't you come down? Sailor played the whole night through, then in the morning went back to the crew. Told them of the daughter fair, the pretty little thing with the golden hair. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Oh, news it soon got all around, and the very next night in Yarmouth town there was 15 sailors pulling on the string. She came down and she let them all in. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Once more, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Oh, won't you come down to Yarmouth?
I think it was Bertolt Brecht who said one time, with a man's dying breath, he should be prepared to make a fresh start. I like that. That's what this next song is about, although it's supposedly about a ship that went down in the 60s off the coast of Nova Scotia, a ship called the Mary Ellen Carter. And there's a lovely last verse to it, which is the moral of the whole thing. And it's a verse that I will tell you because, like myself, you may get solace from it on occasions of tragedy or whatever. It says, all you to whom adversity has dealt the final blow, with smiling bastards lying to you everywhere you go. Turn to and put out all your strength of arm and heart and brain, and like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again. Rise again. Rise again. Though your heart may be broken and your life about to end, no matter what you've lost, be it a home, a love, a friend, like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again. She went down last October in a pouring, driving rain. The skipper, he'd been drinking, and the mate, he felt no pain. Too close to Three Mile Rock when she was dealt her mortal blow, and the Mary Ellen Carter settled low. There was just us five aboard her when she finally was awash. We worked like hell to save her, all heedless of the cost. And the groan she gave as she went down, it caused us to proclaim we'd make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Now the owners wrote her off, not a nickel will they spend. She gave 20 years of service, then met her sorry end. The insurance pay the loss to us, so let her rest below. They laughed at us and said we'd have to go. But we talked of her all winter, some days around the clock. She's worth a quarter million afloat and at the dock. And with every jar that hit the bar, we swore we would remain and make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Rise again, oh rise again. Let her name not be lost to the knowledge of men. All those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. All spring now we've been with her on a barge lent by a friend. Three dives a day in hard hat suit, and twice I've had the bends. Thank God it's only 60 feet and the currents here are slow. I'd never have the strength to go below. Or we patched her rents and stopped her vents, stopped catching porthole down. Put cables to her fore and aft and girded her around. Tomorrow noon we hit the air and then take up the strain and watch the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Rise again, oh rise again. Let our name not be lost to the knowledge of men. All those who loved her best and were with her till the end will make the Mary Ellen Carter rise again. Or we couldn't leave her there, you see, to crumble into scale. She saved our lives so many times, living through the gale. And the laughing drunken rats who left her to her sorry grave, they won't be laughing in another day. All you to whom adversity has dealt the final blow, with smiling bastards lying to you everywhere you go, turn to and put out all your strength of arm and heart and brain, and like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again. Oh, rise again, rise again. Though your heart may be broken and your life about to end, no matter what you've lost, be it a home, a love, a friend, like the Mary Ellen Carter, rise again.
And when night stirred at sea, and fire brought a crowd in, they say that her beauty was like music in mouth, and few in the candlelight thought her too proud. For the house of the planter is known by the trees, and men who had seen her drank deep and were silent. The women were speaking wherever she went, like a bell that is rung, or a wonder told shyly. And oh, she was the Sunday in every week. ¶¶
time.
full of sleep and nodding by the fire. Take down this book and slowly read and dream of the soft look your eyes had once and of their shadows deep. How many loved your moments of glad grace or loved your beauty with love false or true, but one man loved the pilgrim soul in you and loved the sorrows of your changing face. And bending down beside the glowing bars, murmur a little sadly how love fled and paced upon the mountains overhead and hid his face amid a crowd of stars. Was clear, the stars were shining, the moon came up so quiet in the sky, the people gathered round, the bands were cheering, I can hear them now playing coming through the rye. Dressed in blue, you looked so lovely, just a gentle flower of a small town girl. You took my hand, you danced to the music with a single smile, you became my world. And we danced all night to the fiddle and the banjo, their drifting tunes seemed to fill so long ago, but I still remember when we fell in love at the Roseville Fair. We courted well, and we courted dear, and we'd sit for hours in the front porch chair. Then a year went by from the time that I met you, and I made you mine at the Roseville. And we danced all night to the fiddle and the banjo, their drifting tunes seemed to fill the air so long ago, but I still remember when we fell in love at the Roseville Fair. Here's a song for all of the lovers. Here's a tune that they can share. May they dance all night to the fiddle and the banjo the way we did at the Roseville Fair. May they dance all night to the fiddle and the banjo. other rose will bear.
Seamus Ennis, my old friend, says, a young German student asked him one time if he could give him any tips on playing de Baron. And he said, yes, it's best played with a penknife. My sentiments exactly. We used to hang out at O'Donoghue's pub, Marion Row. And when that got too packed, we'd go over to O'Neill's. One time in O'Neill's, there was no singing allowed in O'Neill's. It was a very, very straight-laced pub, and the man behind the bar wore a dicky bow and a swallowtail coat, very well-trimmed moustache. He looked like an undertaker for all the world. I can't remember his name now, but I remember a little. One of the tinker kids coming in one day, opening the door and looking up at him. And he was white as a sheet, you know, and he says to him, hey, mister, how much would you charge for haunting the house? But I was overwhelmed to go in there one day and find, sitting in the corner, Patrick Kavanagh, been a hero of mine from the time I was a teenager when I was working in the insurance office down in Dawson Street. He had only a slim volume of verse that time. But I asked somebody, I can't remember if it was Seamus or somebody else, to be introduced to the great poet Patrick Kavanagh. And to this day, I can say that Patrick Kavanagh is a friend of mine. Because he looked up at me and he went, "Bah!" And I always take that as a great sign of friendship, a tremendous sign of friendship. He had come down from the stony fields of Monaghan down to Dublin, first of all to try and become a priest. I could never really take that seriously. Then he tried to become a civil servant. It was even worse. Failing that, he tried to get any kind of a job at all that had a pension to it, because the Christian Brothers always told us in those days, get a job with a pension. And I always had this strange vision when I heard that, get a job with a pension, of this long straight road with huge big high walls on either side stretching way off into the distance, and down at the end a pension, and just beyond the pension death. And I thought, my God, are those the parameters that we have to live with? You know, what was a frightening prospect. But Kavanagh, failing at everything else, of course, became a poet. And he always thought of himself in terms of farm animals. And he wrote this marvelous poem called Pegasus. Pegasus, of course, was the flying horse of Greek mythology. And Kavanagh said, my soul was an old horse offered for sale at 20 fairs. I offered him to the church. The buyers were little men who feared his unusual airs. There was one said, let him remain unbid in the wind and rain and hunger of sin, and we'll get him. We'll get him with the winkers thrown in for nothing. And then the men of state came to see what I'd brought for sale. There was one minister wondering if another horse body would fit the tail that he kept for sentiment, the relic of his own soul, who said, I'll graze him in lieu of his labor. So I lent him for a week or more. He came back, a hurdle of bones, starved, overworked, in despair. I nursed him on the roadside grass to shape him for another fair. I lowered my price. I stood him where the broken wind had spavined stand.
And crooked shopkeepers said, well, he might do a season on the land. He's not for high-paid work in towns. He'd do a tinker, possibly, I beg. Who'll make me an offer now? A soul is a poor man's tragedy. He'll draw your dungiest cart, show you shortcuts to mass, teach weather lore, at night collect bad debts from poor men's grass. But I would not. So where the tinkers quarreled, I went down with my horse, my soul. I cried, who'll bid me half a crown? From their rowdy bargaining, not one turned. Soul, I prayed, I have hawked you through the world of church and state and meanest trade. But this evening, halter off, never again will it go on. On the south side of ditches, there is grazing in the sun, no more haggling with the world. As I said these words, he grew wings upon his back, and now I may write him every land that my imagination knew.
I'm a free-born man of the traveling people. Got no fixed abode with nomads, I have one. Country lanes and byways were always my ways. I never fancied being numb. Oh, we knew the woods and the resting places, and the small birds sang when winter days were old. Then we'd pack our load and be on the road. Those were good old days for a road. There was open ground where a man could linger for a week or two, for time was not our master. Then away you'd jog with your horse and dog. Nice and easy, no need to go fast. I've hard and I've known it easy, and I've cursed the life when winter days were dawning, but I've laughed and sung through the whole night long, seen the summer sunrise in the morning. All you free-born men know the traveling people. Every tinker, rolling stone and gypsy road. Winds of change are blowing, old ways are going. Your traveling days will soon be over. Inch by inch, row by row, going to make this garden grow.
takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. And inch by inch, row by row, someone blessed these seeds I sow. Someone warmed them from below till the rain comes tumbling down the sink. And inch by inch, row by row, going to make this garden. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Fertile. And inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds and picking stones, man is made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own, 'cause the time is close at hand. Rain for grain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music from the land. And row by row, going to make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. And inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Plant your rows straight and long, temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth will make you strong if you give her love and care. An old crow watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden, I'm as free as that feathered leaf up there. And by row, going to make this garden. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Can't you inch by? Like you mean it, and inch by inch, row by row, going to make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a piece of fertile ground. And inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes down. Till the rain comes tumbling down. Lovely, lovely. You've done real good. New song that you haven't heard before, a song written by Paul here, and a young solicitor from Waterford named Paul Foskin. Called Children After Rain. When the rain comes tumbling down, I thought it would fit in nicely with this one. Children are always the first people after a rainstorm to come out, and we used to get little matchboxes and put a sail on them, a match stuck in the middle. Did you ever do that? Sail it down the gutters? After the rain of napalm in Vietnam, children were the first ones out of what was left of the houses. In Belfast, after a rain of bombing or plastic bullets, children are the first one out of the houses. Children after rain. Beyond the child refugee, never made the news at all.
And as the uniforms parade, she takes her hand down from her face to see the mighty men of war. At 12 years old, she goes to school in faded jeans and faded youth, and memories she can't forget. Her father's dead, her brother blames the UVF, the IRA, or some such piece of alphabet. They're only children after all, a single face, a thousand names, the war we won, the love we lost. They're only children after all, a photograph without a frame, a crucifixion with no cross. The frightened eyes of a lonely child with no lullabies and no nursery rhymes, just another tear to fall across another face. We plant a seed, and the seed will grow. We come to reap what we came to sow. And then we wonder at it all. Will it ever change? Now she laughs, now she cries. She takes it in, and she takes her time. And I can see tomorrow in her eyes. Feel I missed the end. I stay behind, the crowd is gone. I read the cast, the lights come on. But was it really just pretend? They're only children after all, a single face, a thousand names, the war we won, the love we lost. They're only children after rain, a photograph without a frame, a crucifixion with no cross. They're only children after rain.
Oh my God, it's 10:30. We better close up before the bar is closed. I tell you what, sing this one with me. I told you to begin with, that I was going to sing songs that were made by friends. This song was made by a friend named Gene Raskin. We used to drink together back in Greenwich Village years and years ago. Gene Raskin went through very, very hard times in his life. He had a lot of tragedy. And he pulled himself out of it, got himself back in the business, and got himself quite a wealthy man out of this particular song. And I like to think he made it or was inspired by it in our days, drinking at a pub called the White Horse Tavern down in Greenwich Village. He says, "Those were the days, my friends, those were the days." Oh, once upon a time there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two,
Remember how we laughed away the hours and dreamed of all the great things we would do. Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose, we'd fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. Lie, 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 la, lie, la, 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 lie, la, lie, la, 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 la. And then the busy years went rushing by. We lost our starry notions on the way. And if by chance we'd meet outside the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say, those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. The life we choose, we'd fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. Lie, 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 la, lie, la, 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 lie, la, lie, la, 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 just tonight I stood outside the tavern. Nothing seemed the way it used to be. And in the glass I saw a strange reflection. Was that lonely fellow really me? Through the door I heard familiar laughter. I saw your face and heard you call my name. Oh, my friend, we're older but no wiser. Far in our hearts, the dreams are still the same. Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we'd choose, we'd fight and never lose, for we were young and sure to have our way. Lie, 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 la, lie, la, 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 la,
revels now are ended. These are actors, as I foretold you, are all spirits and are melted into air, into thin air. And like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped palaces, the gorgeous towers, the solemn temples, the great globe itself, yea, all which they inherit shall dissolve. And like this insubstantial pageant, faded, leave not a rack behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. What I'm asking you in Shakespeare's words is, have you no homes to go to? We're going to leave you and love you. Thanks for coming. We're going to leave you with a little song called The Journey's End.
Fire is out, the moon is down, the parting glass is dry and done, and I must go and leave this town before the rising of the sun. And long's the road and far's the mile before I rest my soul again with girls that weep and girls that smile and all the words and ways of men. For some there are that may not bide, but wander to the journey's end, nor take a girl to be a bride, nor keep a man to be a friend. And when I'm done with one, I will sit beside the rolling wheel for all the songs I did not sing and promises I did not
stay home. Thanks.
Again, thank you, Paul. Thank you, Martin. Thank you, Jeremy.